All right, in this video, I'm going to prove that if we have a square matrix that is skew symmetric, then its diagonal entries must all be zero. So this is a linear algebra proof. With a lot of linear algebra proofs, I feel like as long as you write out the definition and as long as you know a couple of the matrix properties that are taught, then you can just play around with the definitions that you're given, and then you can find the proof pretty easily. So what I mean by that is this is basically testing, do you know what it means when a matrix is skew symmetric? And then if you do, you can pretty much play around with that, and you should be able to prove that the diagonal entries must all be zero. And that makes sense because if you think about it, so the definition of skew symmetric means that A transpose, if you have a matrix A, equals negative A. So if you have the diagonal entries A11, A22, to ANN, then the transpose, the diagonal entries stay the same on the main diagonal, right? So this will still have to be equal to each other. But it says that the A transpose should be negative values, so this should be negative, negative, negative. So it makes sense that zero is going to be equal to negative zero. But obviously we need to prove that formally. So what I would do is say, okay, let A be an n by n skew symmetric matrix. Yes, my handwriting is bad. Then by definition, A transpose equals negative A. Let A equal Aij between 1 and n for j. So we can write the matrix A in component forms like I just did. So A11, that's when I equals 1 and j equals 1. So we can write it like that. So that means that A transpose equals Aij transpose equals Aji when I is between 1 and n. Thus, we can write A transpose equals negative A equals negative Aij, which we had from here because A transpose equals negative A. And we can also say that this is equal to Aji, and this is for between 1 and n. So this must be true when I equals J, we have. So now we're going to just prove that the diagonals are the same. So we have that Aji J must equal to negative AJJ, and this gives us 2AJJ equals to 0, which gives us that AJJ must equal to 0 when J is between 1 and n. So for all values between 1 and n, the diagonal entries, which is AJJ, will be 0. So that's a pretty sufficient proof that if you have a skew symmetric matrix, then its main diagonal entries must all be 0. And we're done.